how would we practice this? The way we would do this, we're going to combine our three moves, the running man, this modified Charleston, and the T-step. Then we would just do that for a count of four for each of those movements to keep it as simple as possible. Of course, you could do it longer. You could do it for a count of eight. You could do it for a count of 12. Why those numbers? It's just a nice way to get back, you know, to your little starting point. If you stop in the middle of that, you'll be kind of in a weird position. It's going to be hard to transition. But if you keep within counts of four, it's going to be a little bit easier. And you can modify it, of course, down the line. But to start as easily as possible, let's do it to a count of four for each of those movements. So, running man, remember that? One, two, three, four. Now what? What are we going to do now? Modified Charleston. One, two, three, four. That was a sideways version. One, two, three, four. Front and back version. T-step. One, two, three, four. So you notice, two to one side, two to the other side. I didn't do it, go four one way, for the other way. You could, but to me, this is a little bit of a faster move, and it looks kind of good if you combine it with some quicker music. Otherwise, it just seems like too easy of a move. You just keep doing the same thing. You could do that, but to me, it just looks a little bit better. And how about if you did that for like a few rounds? So you get home, you don't feel like practicing this, but what if you just did those three things for three sets? So all you're doing is one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. So one, one, two, three, four, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. So simple. And how long does that take? Next to no time, but it'll help your muscle memory. So if you do this enough, you know, even through a few times throughout the day, you don't have to, you know, dedicate a specific time to do this. You can practice this here and there, you know, a couple times here, a couple times there. Your food's getting ready in the kitchen. Hey, try this, you know. So my point being is, you know, the more you do this, the better you'll get. And even doing that, I'm actually even breathing a little bit harder already. So the other advantage, you know, the older we get, I don't like doing cardio. I should like it. It's good for you, but I don't. And this is a way to get some cardio in a fun way with learning something new, right? It's going to work your calves. It really works kind of, you know, your whole cardiovascular system, obviously, but gives you a nice calf workout too. And plus, you know, your training balance, your, you know, you're just training your whole body. You're learning something new. You know, your brain is getting involved. So to me, I think it's kind of a fun way to you know, try to stay in shape the older we get. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Stay tuned and keep watching the channel. There's just so much more great content. We may have a follow-up video specifically with EDM as far as some additional things you can do, some modified versions of each of these steps or some additional things, you know, to make it even more interesting once you get good at the basics. But we have to get good at the basics first. And that's pretty much it. So again, please like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.